Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. Today I will discuss about scrub typhus. Scrub typhus was first reported by Hakuju Hashimoto, a Japanese researcher, in 1810. However, the disease was more formally described in the early 20th century. In 1908, Nagayo and his colleagues in Japan identified the causative agent, later named Orientia tsutsugamushi. The disease became more widely known due to its impact on soldiers during World War II and the subsequent research into its transmission by infected Chigger mites, which is a larval form of Trombiculid mite. Scrub typhus is an infectious disease caused by the bacteria Orientia tsutsugamushi. It is transmitted to humans through the bite of infected Chigger mites. The disease is common in rural areas of Asia, the Pacific Islands and northern Australia, especially in regions with dense vegetation and scrubland, hence the name scrub typhus. Scrub typhus is endemic in many parts of Asia Pacific, including South Asia, Southeast Asia and the Western Pacific. It is also found in some parts of the Middle East and South America. The disease is most common in rural and forested areas with dense vegetation where infected Chigger mites thrive. Symptoms typically appear 6 to 21 days after the bite and may include high fever, headache, chills and muscle pain, skin rash, Eschar, a black scab-like sore at the bite site, swollen lymph nodes and confusion or altered mental state in severity. If left untreated, scrub typhus can lead to serious complications such as pneumonia, meningoencephalitis, that is brain inflammation, kidney failure, multi-organ failure and death. In severe cases, mortality can be 30 to 40%. Diagnosis may be done by blood tests such as serology, PCR or indirect immunofluorescence. Doxycycline is the first-line antibiotic and early treatment significantly reduces complications. This is all about scrub typhus. Remember, understanding diseases helps us all stay healthy. Thanks for watching this video. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family members to spread awareness. If you have any questions or personal experiences, drop a comment. Don't miss my next video.